Right, I'm joined here now by Shak Pitters and Rushian Hepburn-Murphy, cousins. One's a boxer, one's a footballer. But Shak, picked up your first win, professional debut. How does it feel?
Yeah, I felt good. I had a good amateur background, so I felt relaxed in there. I know what I had to do. It was more just like listen to my coaches, make it a lot easier fight for myself. I didn't know it was like obviously his 100th fight, but he's tough. He took some good shots, and I just had to box smart in there.
There's a lot of confidence you see switching up your stances as well. Is that something that you've been working on?
In the gym I'm always like trying to, I always think of scenarios. I didn't really say much, but I've had an injury to the bicep. Not one that would have jolted me out, but I had to learn just in case it got worse. So now to use the southpaw stance, which I practice a lot in the gym as well. I'm always trying to learn and perfect it.
Sean, coming down as well, you're playing for Villa yourself. What did you make of your cousin's performance?
Obviously, it's his first professional fight, so there's obviously a lot of things to work on. But he did good out there for his first professional fight. Obviously, he's got the win, which is the most important thing. And obviously, there's a lot of learning curves in there. And obviously, he's going to learn from his first professional fight. Obviously, he said the guy's had 100 fights, so he's very experienced. So there's a lot he can learn from him as well.
So, obviously, it seemed like a dominant performance for yourself. What do you feel like you learned from these types of fights when you feel so comfortable and controlled?
You learned a bit. I learned just to more stay calm, listen, not to follow the crowd, listen to the crowd basically and just box my own game, what me and my team went through. If I didn't listen there, the guy's very experienced, as you see, was a pressure fighter, kept coming forward. I could have obviously either, just let it go basically. So I just felt like listening to my team was the main goal.
And then, like I said, one's a boxer, one's a footballer. Like, growing up, did any of you try the other sport?
I used to play football when I was younger. I used to play for West Brom when I was younger. In the younger ages, and obviously us living so close as well, we used to always try to kick football against that one. But he's come on good. He's doing good in his football. I follow it a lot, and it's good to see the family all here supporting me as well. And we all do the same with him.
I speak to your dad, and he was telling me that you used to live above each other.
Yeah.
So, what was that like growing up as kids? I suppose you had a lot of banter, a lot of funny situations going on.
Obviously, always a lot of banter growing up where we grew up. Outside playing, kicking ball, as I said. I tried boxing just for fitness, not as a serious sport, but just for fitness, and it's quite a hard sport. It made it look easy in there, though, to be honest.
You see as well, a lot of footballers do take up boxing now. What's the differences between training as a boxer as training as a footballer?
Obviously, it's just more. It's very intense in the boxing ring. It's quite quick, non-stop as well. It's quite similar to football in certain ways, but different in certain ways also. But both sports are hard as each other, to be honest.
Definitely.
Well, obviously, growing up together, I suppose you feel like a sense of pride in each other, like you're both doing well in your own sports, making it in your own ways.
It speaks for itself. He's doing well, even for Villa, youngest player to come on, man. And it's someone I've just said I grew up with himself, and obviously us being family as well. And it gives me that motivation to want to even do better. He's younger than me, but it gives me that motivation when I'm seeing him in the papers and so on. And he's so professional and level-headed with it, and he's doing great. It's good to see him strive on and doing good.
And then, growing up, was there what types of memories or funny situations, any funny stories you can remember? If one which in particular might stick out.
To be fair, he was more like, I know he was more either house or with other family, like his brother. I was, a lot of the times I used to come and play, his sister Sonia, my cousin as well, I used to come and play this Hungry Hippo game, and I remember she used to always get mad, and I used to get kicked out of the house by our TLA. She used to be like, you're upsetting her now, so get out of the house. So there was a lot of funny situations that we always used to have. But it's always been great memories, we've never had no animosity or anything, most people fall out. We've always wanted the best for each other, and as we say, he's here and he didn't have to be here. And I appreciate all the family being here as well.
And Rushian, coming back off your injury now, how's your injury? How's your healing up there?
My injury's healed up quite well. It's been a long 3 months, but I'm getting there. Starting to do running outside, getting back to fitness, and hopefully train next week and see where I can go from there.
Think you might join your cousin in the ring with a bit of sparring?
Yeah, I think I'll come out on top in that one.
It's alright, I'll say that.
Ben, obviously, you're on your new contract now. How happy are you to just focus on your football now?
Yeah, I'm buzzing to get out of the way. A lot of weight, take it off my shoulders, and I can just focus and get to where I need to be and get to where I want to be, and hopefully getting around that first team.
Is that your aim now? Rest of the year, just getting first team, just get a few games under your belt.
I just want to work hard, knuckle down, do what I got to do in training, get the gaffer's eye on me, and hopefully he can put his trust in me and get me in that first team.
As a family now, you know, you guys are all out celebrating tonight.
You know, I'm thinking about the next one now. I mean, my plan is, you know, for everyone who actually came, I'll show the support and love. If they want to go somewhere, we go somewhere. But I'm a professional boxer, so I'll be back in the gym, you know, after a couple of days, working on what I've done wrong. And, you know, I want to go far in the sport. So I think if I want to go far, it's something where I've got to stay disciplined and do that.
What would you like to achieve, say, by the end of the year? You know, where would you like to be at?
I don't want to jump ahead of the gun. I just want to basically, each person to put ahead in front of me at the moment, it's experience, it's a learning curve. There's big fights out there, but I'm going to stay in my lane, get the win off. You know, keep winning fights is the main goal, and hopefully when those come, and if I could get on a big, you know, Eddie Hearn show or a big show, then I'm 100% going to take my opportunity.
Then, Shak, I know you've just started out with Rushian, you know, you've had a time as a footballer now, but have you ever had any funny or weird situations where someone's recognised you in public and asked for a photo and autograph?
I've had quite a few situations, to be honest. I can't think of the funniest one.
But I'll give you an example. I was interviewing Chordini earlier, yeah, and he was telling me about he was changing his daughter's nappy in a service station, and someone waited for him to get a picture with him.
I can't really think of any funny situation. There's been a lot of encounters where people have come up to me and asked for pictures, but I can't really think of one particular one.
Is it crazy? We're both so young, you know, you're starting to get recognised. Yeah. Is it crazy, you know, seeing other people just come up to you and ask you for a photo or an autograph, like I say?
I just gotta soak up the moments, soak up the memories, and obviously, hopefully, if my career goes where I want it to go, there'll be a lot more of that. So, right about now, I'm just soaking up all the experience that comes along. I'm just trying to do well in the sport.
Well, from the sounds of it, by the time you retire, you could try boxing for give your cousin a run for his money.
Why do you want us to fight each other?
It's money, man. I can promote that. You whack it on my YouTube channel. Yeah. Right, cheers, guys.
Thanks so much, man. Appreciate it.